Now, let's look at enols, and in particular talk about how we get from a carbonyl form to an enol form, this process of tautomerization. You've seen this before, at least a couple of times, but it's been a while. So let's go back and look at this again. And we have actually two options. We have an acid-catalyzed pathway and actually a base-catalyzed pathway. Now these two pathways are almost the same. They just flip around the order of what happens first. And what happens first, in many respects, parallels what we've seen before. So as you might guess, in an acid-catalyzed pathway for this equilibrium, and it is an equilibrium, we're going to start off with some sort of acid. I'll just use that generic H+. And that H+ will serve to protonate the carbonyl. We've done that before, many times. We protonate the carbonyl. In the past, we've protonated the carbonyl in general to make it more electrophilic. That's not what we're trying to do here. We aren't really reacting this with a nucleophile. But we can use that same idea, the same pair of resonance contributors, getting to this point where now we can regenerate our acid catalyst. Remember, I said acid catalyst. We've consumed it here. We better regenerate it. We can, simply by losing a proton, alpha, or next door to our carbonyl. So if we lose that, put that electron density down there to form the alkene, what we've done is protonated on oxygen, deprotonated or regenerated that acid off of carbon to go from our carbonyl form to our enol form. The base pathway, we just flip that around. We reverse things. So with base, we don't have a proton to put on there, but we can remove a proton. And so I will use hydroxide as a generic base. We'll remove one of those alpha protons next door to the carbonyl. We will generate an anion. So, in essence, we've generated an enolate here at the moment, which we can draw either with the negative charge on carbon or a resonance contributor in which that negative charge is instead on oxygen, and we have the pi system here. And then since it's a base catalyzed pathway, we better regenerate our base. So here in this case, using hydroxide, our protonated form of our base is water. So we can use the negative charge here, remove a hydrogen off of water, regenerate hydroxide, and wind up now with our enol form. So very similar, just do you add a proton and then remove one, or do you remove a proton and then add one? And both of these processes absolutely can be operational. We'll see the acid-catalyzed tautomerization is the one that we're going to use more, but they're both present.